Hi, my name is Michael Burton with michaelburtonfilms.org, located in Salt Lake City, Utah, and we're here talking about using Microsoft Windows. Now what I want to talk to you about is how to play a Music City on your computer. Let me start out by saying that Windows XP is a registered trademark of Microsoft, and I am in no way affiliated with Microsoft. When we place a Music City in the computer, it automatically should bring up a menu that gives you a bunch of options of what you can do with that CD and what are the different types of players that you can play that music in. As you can see here, it says audio CD. These are our options. We can play or save the music from the audio CD. We can rip the music from the CD, play the audio CD in the Media Center or in Windows Media Player. We can also import them into Rhapsody. We could also play them in iTunes. There are many different options. The other way to do it is to just open the folder to view the files that are on the CD, the individual tracks, and you can play the individual tracks on any one of those players as well, instead of viewing the entire album. What we're going to go ahead and do is we're going to go ahead and choose to play the audio CD using the Windows Media Player. Now we can also check right here to say always do the selected action, so that automatically when you put a music CD in, it'll automatically play it in that player. But I like to leave it unchecked just because then I have my options. We're going to click OK, and this automatically brings up the music in the music player. And as you can see here, to the right, you've got your track list of all the tracks that are on the CD. And this, of course, is Windows Media Player. You also have the option, if you come up here to the top, you have the option to rip the CD or to burn. Burn is more for, like it says, burning files to CDs, where you can actually burn a music CD, either for playback in your computer or somewhere else. But ripping the music from the audio CDs has always helped me, because I can listen to my CDs, or I can actually, especially now in the digital age, I can rip the music from the CDs, keep them on my computer. I can also network them to like my Xbox 360 on my network and play the music in my living room from my computer, from my sub, you know, from my station. Then I can also, change the format, make them into MP3s, put them on my iPod, things like that. So that's a good way to, so that you don't have to always be putting your CDs in. But if you put your CDs in, again, it'll give you that automatic menu it'll automatically pop up with that menu and give you some options as to what to do. Another way to do this, if the menu doesn't pop up for some reason, is you go over to your start menu, and then you can go over to My Computer. When you click on My Computer, it'll bring up right here, these are all your devices. And right now it's saying that there's an audio CD in my G drive. That's my top DVD burning drive on my computer. The H drive is my DVD drive. But my audio CD is in my DVD drive. I can either right click on this and click play. I can also go ahead and open and view one of the individual tracks. Or I can just double click on the icon and it does the same thing. It opens it right up. I have my default set to Windows Media Player. You can also change your default to iTunes or Rhapsody or whatever you deem necessary for you to use.